Hello and welcome to this video lecture. Today we will discuss about the suspension system. I am Vijay Bendavade. So these are the contents of this particular topic. Includes the introduction, objectives, basic considerations, etc. So starting with basically what is suspension system? The parts which perform the function of isolating the automobile from the road shocks are collectively known to be suspension system. See in this figure, this particular suspension system includes the spring as well as damper. What it do basically? It absorbs the shock energy coming from the road surface and isolates the vehicle body from this particular oscillation as well as the vibration. So spring actually oscillates with respect to vibration coming from the shock energy. And what damper can do? Damper is nothing but the shock absorber which restricts the oscillation of the spring to the reasonable level. So these are the objectives of this particular suspension system. First one is to isolate the vehicle body from the road surface. Second one is to safeguard the occupants in the vehicle. Third one is to preserve the stability of the vehicle. So what are the design considerations for suspension system? So these are the total main six considerations for the suspension system or design of suspension system. First one is the vertical loading. It includes basically the total load of the vehicle body as well as the occupant inside the vehicle. Second one is the rolling. Under this consideration, center of gravity of vehicle is taken into account. Center of gravity of vehicle body should be considerably above the ground so as to avoid rolling action for vehicle while taking the turn. This is due to when vehicle is taking turn, the centrifugal force acts outward from the center of gravity and road resistance acts inward direction, which causes rolling phenomena. So for design of suspension system, it has to be taken into account to avoid the rolling. Third one is the brake dip and acceleration squat. What it means? On braking, nose of vehicle has frequency to lower or dip, as well as in same way during the acceleration, frontal area of vehicle is lifted somewhat. It is called acceleration squat. So for proper design of a suspension system, these two phenomena has to be considered. Next one is the road holding. It is nothing but the degree up to which vehicle maintains the contact between the road surface and under various type of directional changes. Next one is ride and handling. Ride is the ability of vehicle to provide the smooth, comfortable drive on bumpy road, whereas handling is the ability of vehicle to safely accelerate, brake and corner. Next is sprung and unsprung weight. It is weight, first of all the sprung weight. It is the weight supported by the vehicle's suspension system. It includes frame, body, engine and entire transmission system. Whereas what is unsprung weight? Unsprung weight is the weight of vehicle components between suspension and road surface, and it includes axle assembly, wheels, tires, brakes, etc. So next one is the classification of spring. Depending upon type of material used, the springs are subdivided into steel springs, rubber springs, plastic, air springs and hydraulic springs. So in this lecture we will cover some important springs. First one is the leaf spring. This is the stage of the leaf spring. It is a semi-elliptical type construction, consists of number of leaves. known as blades. Blades are bound together by the cleat or strap. The Landeer swing or Landeer blade has eyes on its end. This is what the eyes on its end. One end of the spring is mounted on a frame with a simple pin, which is also known as a fixed point, and other end is connected to the shackle, which is movable point. Why one end is movable? Because spring has to accommodate itself on account of changes in the length with respect to vibration. So working, how it works? When vehicle comes across the projection of road surface, the wheel moves up, deflecting the spring. This is what the leaf spring, which deflects due to the projection on the road surface. This changes in the length between the shackle and fixed point. So due to this particular upliftment of the wheel, the length of the spring or length of the blade of a spring going to be changed. This length between the shackle and fixed point change for the accommodating the vibration. When leaf spring deflects, the upper side of each leaf tip slides or rubs against each other. This produces some damping which reduces the vibration. So these are the spring materials. First one is the chrome vanadium steel, second one is the silico manganese steel, and third one is the carbon steel. Next one is the problem involves in the leaf spring and its remedies. Due to rubbing friction, it produces the squeaking sound. Squeaking sound is nothing but some kind of frictional sound is there, is nothing but the squeaking sound. Next one, if moisture is present, such interleaf friction will lead to the corrosion. So what are its remedies to avoid such a problems? Actually, prevention is better than cure. So with that fact, the phosphate paint may reduce this problem of squeaking sound. The phosphate paint are generally applied on the leaf spring to avoid squeaking sound. Second one is the periodically lubrication and cleaning of spring is necessary to avoid such a problem. Next one is the coil spring. So this is the pictorial representation of the coil spring. It is a simple helical type spring or construction. The advantages of using coil over leaf springs are: it has little to no damping, it is having low cost and compact size, see here. Its weight is half of the leaf spring for doing same job. Also, another important fact is that it can store twice the energy per unit volume in compression of or in comparison with the leaf spring. But to control in acceleration, braking and cornering, anti-roll bars, see here, this is the stabilizing bar is required for with respect to this particular spring to avoid the acceleration, braking and cornering defects by using only this spring. So coil spring with the support of a stabilizing bar is used for suspension system. Thank you. We will see the next concept in next lecture. Thank you.